What's up, you guys? Konnichiwa. My name is Ryan, and I am your Japanese American sensei. And today we're going to be continuing our Japanese 101 series. And today we are going to be going over adjectives. Real quick, if you're looking to take your Japanese to the next level, please give this video a like, subscribe, and leave any questions or comments about anything Japanese language related down below, and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Without further ado, let's jump into the video. So there's a few things about adjectives you should know. The first thing being that all adjectives end with an E sound, which makes learning adjectives extremely easy because as soon as you hear that E sound in any part of the sentence, you can pretty much be assured that that is an adjective. All right, let's jump into my notebook so you can see what I'm talking about and learn how to conjugate these adjectives. All right, so we are here again in my notebook, and again, we have our matrix: affirmative, negative, present slash future, and past. So starting at this upper left box here, we have our affirmative. So we have our first adjective here, 大きい. And 大きい means big. Now, as I mentioned earlier, all adjectives end in E. So you see, the last character of this word is E, indicating it is an adjective. Now to complete the idea or the phrase or the sentence for this box, we follow this rule and we just add this to E. So we have 大きい plus this. So 大きいです this is it is big, or it's big. Okay, now we can take the next one, which is small, which is 小さい, 小さい. So again, we see the E here, so we know it is an adjective, and to complete the sentence or the phrase, we just add des to this part of the word. So 小さいです des, and that is, it is small, or it's small. Okay, so we'll just use one more example. So, okay, let's take the word 高い. So 高い is tall or expensive. Okay, so 高い. Okay, so to complete this, we just add this. So 高いです. It is tall or it is expensive. You'll know what it is just based on the context. If you're in a store, then obviously it's expensive. If you're looking at a building, then obviously it's high, okay? So moving on, the past affirmative. So again, we have our adjective. Let's use the opposite of 高い or expensive, and that is 安い. 安い is cheap. 安い is cheap, okay? So again, we have our adjective indicator here with the E. And the rule for this one is you cross out the E, or you get rid of the E, and you add 買った this. Okay, so 買った is the past tense, and then you just add this to that. Okay, so 安い becomes 安い. And then we get rid of the E, and then we add katta, replace it with katta. So, yasu katta desu. Okay? Yasukatta desu. Yasukatta desu. That was cheap. Okay? Or it was cheap. Okay? Let's use another one. Atsui. Atsui is hot, right? So we have the E, indicating that it's an adjective. Now what we do is we get rid of it, and we replace it with katta, and then we add desu. So this becomes atsu katta desu. Okay? Atsukatta desu. Atsukatta desu. It was hot. Alright, so let's do one more for repetition. And we have the opposite of atsui, and that is samui. Samui is cold. So again, we see the e, we get rid of it, and we replace it with katta desu. Okay, so that would be samu katta desu. Samu katta desu. It was cold. Okay, so let's just underline this so you know exactly what's going on. All right, so moving up to this box, the negative and present slash future conjugation. Let's just recycle one of the old adjectives that we used for the first box. So we have 大きい here, and 大きい is big. 大きい. Okay, so again, we have the e indicating it's the adjective. We get rid of that and we replace it with ku plus arimasen. Okay, so 大きい becomes 大きくありません. Okay? 大きくありません. 大きくありません. And that means it is not big. 大きくありません. Okay? So let's take the next one again. 小さい, which is small. 小さい. We see we have the e here indicating it's an adjective, so we can replace that with ku and then add arimasen. Okay, so this chisai becomes chisaku arimasen. Chisaku arimasen. It's not small. And we use the last one for repetition. We have takai, which is tall or expensive. Takai. So we see the e here, we get rid of that, and we replace it with ku, and then we add arimasen. Okay, so that is takaku arimasen. Takaku arimasen. It's not expensive. So I'll just underline the ku here so we can see that the ku, it used to be an e, and then we just add arimasen after that. Okay? Alright, moving down to this last box, we have the negative past conjugation. And again, let's recycle those words that we used for the other past tense box. So here we have yasui, which is cheap. We notice the e here, which is an adjective, and we replace that again with ku, and then instead of arimasen, we add arimasen deshita. So the deshita makes it past tense, okay? So yasui becomes yasuku arimasen deshita. Yasuku arimasen deshita. Yasuku arimasen deshita. Okay? It's kind of long, but this is just how it is. It just kind of flows right off the tongue. Yasuku arimasen deshita. It wasn't cheap. Okay? So the next one, we have atsui. Again, recycling the words. Atsui. And then we have the e here, which we replace it with ku, and then we add arimasen deshita. So, atsuku arimasen deshita. Okay, so atsui becomes atsuku arimasen deshita. Atsuku arimasen deshita. It wasn't hot. Okay, and then again, the last word is samui. Samui. Again, we see the e, which is an adjective. We replace that with ku, and then we add arimasen deshita. So samui becomes samuku arimasen deshita. Samuku arimasen deshita. Samuku arimasen deshita. It wasn't cold. Okay? Well, guys, that is all for this video. Congratulations again for making it to the end, because this is a lot of information, and I know the rest of the 101 series kind of has a lot of information as well. But please be sure to watch this video again, watch my other 101 series videos again multiple times, because this is going to form your foundation for really having a solid understanding of the Japanese language. But once you get it, you'll realize that, see, it's not that hard. In fact, it's pretty easy. But again, if you found this video helpful by any means, please feel free to give it a like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, and leave me any questions or comments down below, and I will get back to them as soon as possible. Thank you again for watching. Arigatou gozaimasu, and I will see you in the next video. Ja, mata ne!